time to lace them up for the Tip-Off Lowdown. Brought to you by your area Pilot Food Marts and Pilot's My Rewards Loyalty Card. Let's head downtown for the Tip-Off Lowdown on the Big Orange Tip-Off Club. Now, here's your host, Gary Lowe.
Good morning and welcome to another terrific weekend of Tip-Off Lowdown. Big Orange Tip-Off Club members welcome another high-profile luncheon speaker this week who's achieved success in basketball with ties to the University of Tennessee. We'll have that keynote speech from here in downtown Knoxville in just a moment, but first, coming up on the show this morning, we'll have your personal invitation to join the Big Orange Tip-Off Club and high schoolers shine in the spotlight. All coming up on Tip-Off Lowdown. Now let's hear from our featured speaker at this week's Big Orange Tip-Off Club luncheon.
Everybody knows Rick Byrd. Rick, whether you know this or not, this whole community loves you. East Tennessee loves you with the name that you have and the way that you have done yourself and the winning record that you've done over at Belmont. Everybody has watched your career. We're just so proud of you. Glad to have you here. Rick has won 805 games. 805. That puts him in the 12th of active coaches of all-time wins. So he's right here from South Doyle. Now, here's another trivia question. What was his number when he was on the junior varsity? He didn't remember. So let's get Rick Byrd. Rick.
Oh, gosh. I did a lot. I want to introduce a couple of folks, several people. My wife, Cheryl, is sitting up here with me. If I told you that she played for the Lady Buffaloes in high school, would you know what high school that would be? Anybody in the room?
Ventress County.
No, it's close to Ventress County, but the actual
Jamestown?
School, no, not Jamestown. Clark Range Lady Buffaloes. She's a proud Lady Buffalo. I'm a South Knoxville boy. How many of you read, heard my dad talk, knew my dad, Ben Byrd, from the Knoxville Journal? How many of you in here?
Carried his paper.
Everybody says the same things about the kind of person he was. And if I learned anything at all from my dad, it was humility. And sometimes I wonder if you talk about yourself like you have humility, that you actually have any humility. But I'm trying to tell you that it was important to him. Well, it wasn't important to him. It's who he was. It's how he was. He didn't care if he got credit or anything else. And I learned how valuable that character trait is. And he was just good to people all the time. And a great writer. I've already had almost 10 people come up to me and tell me a Ben Byrd story about what he wrote or how he treated somebody. And I'm lucky to be his son and proud of him. I went to Galbraith Elementary School for a while, Mount Olive Elementary School for a while. I went to Doyle High School before it was South Doyle. I was in the first class that walked into the building in 1967 when it opened up. Played for Pat Robinette, who was my favorite player at Tennessee when he was their point guard in 1965. I played Little League Baseball at Mary Vestal Park, a Little League field that had a grass infield. I thought it was Yankee Stadium. I played Biddy League Basketball at Lamar Street Gym. How many of you know Lamar Street Gym? That's where my career peaked at about 9 or 10. I would have been a lottery pick at 9 years old, I think. They had 8-foot goals, and the clocks for the games actually had hands that moved around like this. And you just really had to watch it for about 4 seconds before you realized how much time was left in the quarter. Played golf at Dean Hill, like Galbraith Elementary School, no longer really there, and Bays Mountain Country Club. When I got lucky, I got to play around at Holston Hills, tennis at Tyson Park. So I'm Knoxville through and through. Jimmy and Phil and I used to sneak on to Tennessee's football practice field and play two-on-two touch football. Don't tell Coach Fulmer. Went to Ray Mears basketball school. It was held out at Webb School when Webb School was in the middle of nowhere. I went to see the Knoxville Smokies play at Belmont Stadium. I went to every UT football game I could. As I got older, I actually ran the elevator. I'm assuming they have push buttons now, but I ran the elevator to the press box. One of my jobs was to wait on the assistant coach. I had to stop my elevator when it was almost halftime so I could take the assistant coaches down so they could go meet with the team. And so I'd do that. Football coaches would just bang on the elevator like it would make it go faster. Football coaches are crazy. They're crazy. They really are. And if you saw them in that situation, you'd understand what I'm talking about.
We'll have more of our keynote speech at this week's tip-off luncheon in just a moment. But first, with camaraderie and inside basketball info like this, why not join the club? Just go online and click on bigorangetipoff.com. Go to the membership page and fill out an application. You have the option of submitting the application online or downloading the application and mailing it in with payment. The Big Orange Tip-Off Club would love to have you. Why not join today? Next on Tip-Off Lowdown, this week's featured speaker shares more basketball war stories. And later, your chance to show off your Vols photography right here on Tip-Off Lowdown.
Tip-Off Lowdown with the Big Orange Tip-Off Club is brought to you by your area Pilot Food Marts and Pilot's My Rewards Loyalty Card. And Prompt Physical Therapy next to Lakeshore Park in Bearden.
Pilot, wherever you are, there's sure to be a Pilot right on your way. And when you stop in, use that Pilot My Rewards card to save on Monster Energy. 16-ounce cans, two for just $3.50, only at Pilot.
Who says quality can't be quit? From artwork to memorabilia, Express Frame can help you protect and show off your prized possessions. Same quality, same people, new name. Express Frame in the Commons Shopping Center on North Peters Road.
Take a tour of Big Orange basketball history at the Hoops Museum in North Knoxville. This nonprofit collection preserves UT men's basketball memorabilia. Historian R. Larry Smith shares more than 100 years of Vols, including the Ray Mears era, to today's team. Displayed are dozens of vintage Tennessee artifacts. Hoops Museum tours are free. Just bring a game program, ticket stub, or sports page to help R. Larry Smith round out this historic tribute. Phone 865-679-4106 to plan your Hoops Museum visit.
Pilot, wherever you are, there's sure to be a Pilot right on your way. And when you stop in, use that Pilot My Rewards card to save on fresh Mayfield milk. Just $3.99, only at Pilot.
Welcome back to Tip-Off Lowdown with the Big Orange Tip-Off Club, brought to you by your area Pilot Food Marts and by Pilot's My Rewards Loyalty Card. The new Sentinel Reader Survey ranks Pilot Food Marts Knoxville's number one convenience store. They say Pilot delivers service that is fast, friendly, and clean. And now, when you're filling up at Pilot and you need cash, there's no service fee at Pilot's brand new ATMs. And when you're picking up your lottery tickets at Pilot, try a cup of the best coffee in town, roasted right here in Knoxville by Goodson Brothers Coffee. All for you at your area Pilot Food Marts. Now let's hear more from our featured speaker at this week's Big Orange Tip-Off Club Luncheon.
When I was a kid, my dad covered Tennessee basketball. That was his beat. I would sell programs, even in Armory Fieldhouse, and then when Stokely was new, until a reason I sold programs, I think they were 10 cents. I was going to say maybe a quarter, but I think still 10 cents. And the reason I did that is because when the buzzer blew to start the game, I could quit selling programs, and I would run, and I would sit underneath my dad's seat on the edge of the floor before they had all the fancy scoreboards that had stuff in front of them, you know. And so I can't help but believe that that had everything to do with what I ended up doing. Coach Mears is about the end of the table for me right down here, and I'm watching Nate Offerup and some great coaches down on the other end. I saw Tennessee beat the 1966 Kentucky team for their first loss of the year before they lost to Texas Western in the championship game. Danny Schultz is my favorite player ever, and I watched Ron Whidbey and Bill Justice and Jimmy England and so many great players. I saw Pete Maravich come in as a freshman. He was not eligible. Freshmen weren't eligible when he was a freshman, but because he was putting up the numbers. Coach Mears knew a good ticket sales thing when he saw it, and so he brought LSU's freshman team up here, and I got to see him as a freshman. From that point on, I waited around on recruiting because I was waiting for UCLA or Coach Mears or somebody to say that I was good enough to play basketball for them, and they were correct, and I wasn't. So I went to Central Florida Community College and put on a uniform for a year and didn't play a whole lot down there and came back and became a quote-unquote normal student at Tennessee for 2 years. And then freshmen became eligible. Ernie Grunfeld's time, Bernard King a year later, and A.W. Davis was coaching was on the coaching staff, asked me to come walk on, be their point guard. So I played junior varsity for a year when it was kind of a mix of scholarship players, non-scholarship players. I would practice with the junior varsity from say 1 to 3, and then I would practice, and Coach Mears' practices were like 3 to 6 or 6:30, it seemed like. So I was practicing 4 or 5 hours a day. Didn't make me any better basketball player, but maybe I learned a few things along the way. And then the next year I was a student assistant and still practiced with the varsity. So I got to play against Ernie Grunfeld and Bernard King pretty much every day. And to this day, I think Bernard King is the best college basketball player I've ever been around. He was a spectacular talent and unbelievable competitor. College sports and student athletes, I think we need to remember that as coaches that we are a huge part of the education of our student athletes. And in my case, maybe only 15 guys a year am I having. You throw in managers and people that you come in contact every day, maybe 20, 25 young kids that you're impacting their lives, but you are in a tremendous way. And I think we've gotten so tied up into winning national championships or we've just gotten so tied up in the competitiveness of it, in the game only stuff, and we don't care about what we're teaching those kids. And what we're teaching them is how the coach and the coaching staff acts every day, how they act, what they say, how they say it, how they do it. That's what kids are learning from us. I can stand on a soapbox and say that in our program we didn't use or allow profanity, and we'd have differences of opinion about that probably in here, but I don't know why it's okay for a college coach to use profanity if it's not okay for the English teacher or the math teacher to use it to college students. And heck, anymore, maybe that's okay. I hope not.
Who says quality can't be quick? With all our work done right in store, Express Frame can handle all of your custom framing needs. Same quality, same people, new name. Express Frame in the Commons Shopping Center on North Peters Road.
In 1931, Eccles West started selling Chevrolets in East Tennessee. And 4 generations later, the West Chevrolet family continues the tradition. We're proud of our rich history and Smoky Mountain heritage. We know our customers' needs and understand our role in the local community. Now, we invite you to visit our bright new dealership. And when you're ready for your next vehicle, come see us at West Chevrolet, where we try to treat every customer like a part of the family.
this is Julie for Old City Kitchens, inviting you to visit our new kitchen showroom located in the Old City in downtown Knoxville. Whatever your taste or budget, Old City Kitchens delivers the best cabinet value in East Tennessee. Whether you prefer traditional raised panel cabinets, rustic natural hickory cabinets, or the hottest selling shaker style cabinets, Old City Kitchens has a cabinet style for the most discriminating customer. So if you want a better kitchen at a better price, shop Old City Kitchens, making dream kitchens affordable. We'll see you in the Old City.
But we have from Maryville, if she will, Miss Fritz. Dina, if you'll stand, she's our player of the week. Now get this, she's, give her a hand. This young lady is averaging, Alex, she's averaging 22 points a game and 11 rebounds a game. That's good. And she's at Maryville. And right now, you all are 25-3?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, and you're just a junior, correct?
Yes, sir.
All right. Well, stay a little bit after because they want to film you and interview you for the TV. So, thank you for coming. She's got her dad with her. So, let's give him a hand.
I think pretty good coaching, and then we're just not selfish players. We know who needs the ball at certain times, and we're always open to give up our shot for an even better shot. It means a whole lot. Just you know, family is, they're always there for you, and another basketball award is always great, and I think it'll motivate my teammates to keep moving forward in the tournament.
Next on Tip Off Lowdown, UT fans show their Big Orange spirit, and later, your chance to help promote Tennessee basketball.
Pilot, wherever you are, there's sure to be a Pilot right on your way. And when you stop in, use that Pilot My Rewards card to save on fresh Mayfield milk. Just $3.99, only at Pilot.
Who says quality can't be quick? With all our work done right in store, Express Frame can handle all of your custom framing needs. Same quality, same people, new name. Express Frame in the Commons Shopping Center on North Peters Road.
Pilot, wherever you are, there's sure to be a Pilot right on your way. Pilot is your lottery and IC headquarters. And every time you use your Pilot My Rewards card, you'll save 3 cents off of every gallon of gas. Only at Pilot.
Welcome back to Tip-Off Lowdown with the Big Orange Tip-Off Club, brought to you by your area Pilot Food Marts. You know, injuries are part of most competitive games, including basketball. It's unfortunate, but there is help available. If you or your young athlete need rehabilitation, check out Prompt Physical Therapy located next to Lakeshore Park in Bearden. Prompt offers hands-on rehab. The therapists at Prompt Physical Therapy are very skilled. They work with athletes, non-athletes, the elderly, and anyone who has an issue which can be improved through hands-on rehab. Ask your doctor if physical therapy is an option to address your pain, and if so, consider a hands-on approach at Prompt Physical Therapy. Remember, you do have a choice. Now let's hear more from our featured speaker at this week's Big Orange Tip-Off Club Luncheon.
As I've pulled away and heard from former players, and I just had a remarkably fortunate evening where Saturday night they named the basketball court at Belmont for me. But and I think that winning some games had something to do with that, and being there 33 years. But I think, and by the things the president said, it was a lot of the other stuff that mattered. And so, just a couple. I just think we have to have standards, and kids have to understand it, because not many of them are going to go play and make millions of dollars afterwards, and they're going to have to know how to interview for a job, and how to behave, how to say the right things, how to be polite, and I just think we're missing chances when all we do is try to take these guys and turn them into winning teams at any cost and whatever we say and however we do it. So, and Burton could, I could bring Burton up here and he could tell you all these things, but appearance, for example. I mean, when we went on the road, and we don't travel by charter, but when we went on the road and you're out there in front of people, then we had airport clothes. That's all I had to say, we're wearing airport clothes. And that was not jeans, that was not hats, that was not t-shirts. That was tucked in shirts and something besides sneakers and looking presentable all the time. we went in hotels, when we traveled, when we went in a restaurant to eat. Some of my very favorite things are a bus driver telling us. And I'll tell you a story about we played in the NIT in Georgia several years ago. Burton, you were probably in that game. We beat Georgia down there. And the policeman, they assign you at the SEC level, a policeman to stay with the head coach. And as he's walking Cheryl and I to the bus, like somebody's going to attack me back in the locker rooms, you know. Anyway, he just said, I've been doing this for 20 years, and that's the finest behaved team we've ever had in here. And we got that from people in restaurants and hotels and everywhere else. And so it's that kind of stuff that our players tell me ended up mattering to them 5 and 10 years down the road. They don't say, you remember that out-of-bounds play you drew up and we won the game, or anything like that. They talk about the other stuff. And so I just think we all forget, you guys forget, that we got young people that are turning into men or women while they're with us. And all of us need to remember that they're going to make mistakes, they're going to do the wrong things, and we got to help them get better in so many ways. So you watch ESPN and they're all walking into the arena and they got their headphones on, and heck, tennis players come out on tennis courts these days with guys are out there practicing shooting with their music in their ears. I love music, but nobody likes music that much. That's about being cool. But so when you walk into a place and you've got those on and you're walking by people, you can't respond to them. You can't say, nice to see you, thank you very much, yes ma'am, no sir. All they see is, man, he's listening to his music. He's locked in. He's cool. It's rude is what it is. It's rude. We didn't have cell phones out at any of our team meals. They weren't allowed. I think we've forgotten to teach kids about sportsmanship, helping guys off the board. You don't have to hate the team you're playing to beat them. Maybe a little bit during the game. But you can reach down and pick them up off the floor, and it doesn't hurt your chances. And how we acted on the floor was huge to us. And our guys got that. And, yeah, they get irritated every now and then at an official's call. But they didn't make a big deal out of it because they knew it was important to our program that how they acted on the floor, how they act on the campus. They're not better than anybody else on that campus. They can jump higher or shoot better, but they're not any better. They don't get special consideration. They shouldn't act like they deserve special consideration. And teaching that to those kids is important, and I think that's really lost at the highest levels of college athletics where these kids are getting all this kind of attention. And so they think they're really something else. But when they leave and they're no longer really something else, they got a long way to climb to understand how to be, how to live, I think. So that's my soapbox, 2 cents worth about how coaches should lead. You can still win games in a big time, big way. If you just expect your kids to have higher standards of the way they behave and the way they represent your school.
Each weekend, we include your photos right here in Big Orange Country. We'd like to add your Vols and Lady Vols images here, so please send us your basketball-related photos or video. You can check out these pictures and others on Facebook. Just go to the Tip-Off Lowdown Facebook page, and you can submit your photos or videos there or by email at tipofflowdown@comcast.net. Get them to us either way, and we'll put them on the show. Coming up on Tip-Off Lowdown, find out how you can support Big Orange basketball right here in East Tennessee.
Pilot, wherever you are, there's sure to be a Pilot right on your way. And when you stop in, use that Pilot My Rewards card to save on Monster Energy. 16-ounce cans, 2 for just $3.50, only at Pilot.
Take a tour of Big Orange basketball history at the Hoops Museum in North Knoxville. This nonprofit collection preserves UT men's basketball memorabilia. Historian R. Larry Smith shares more than 100 years of Vols, including the Ray Mears era, to today's team. Displayed are dozens of vintage Tennessee artifacts. Hoops Museum tours are free. Just bring a game program, ticket stub, or sports page to help R. Larry Smith round out this historic tribute. Phone 865-679-4106 to plan your Hoops Museum visit.
Who says quality can't be quit? From artwork to memorabilia, Express Frame can help you protect and show off your prized possessions. Same quality, same people, new name. Express Frame in the Commons Shopping Center on North Peters Road.
Hi, I'm Joel for Knox Trail Salvage. Our products are installed all over East Tennessee, and they speak for themselves. For over 37 years, East Tennesseans have trusted Knox Trail Salvage to deliver a quality product at a fair price. Whatever your dream home is, we have a product for every taste and every budget. Our selection is unmatched in East Tennessee. Thanks for listening, and remember, come see us at Knox Trail Salvage. We're making home improvement affordable.
Pilot, wherever you are, there's sure to be a Pilot right on your way. And when you stop in, use that Pilot My Rewards card to save on fresh Mayfield milk. Just $3.99, only at Pilot.
Welcome back to Tip-Off Lowdown with the Big Orange Tip-Off Club, brought to you by your area Pilot Food Marts and by Pilot's My Rewards loyalty card.
Yeah, all these orange jackets around here, you know, remind me, we had to wear coat and tie to our pregame meal when I was quote-unquote playing
Green Jello.
At UT. Green Jello and milkshakes and kind. But we had to wear that, and I mean, it was uncomfortable, and I ended up, some of you may know, I wore a sweater vest and a shirt, and because the jacket would have come off in the first 5 minutes anyway. The first time I got mad at an official's call, I would have thrown my jacket somewhere. But a lot of it. I think as you go, and I was a head coach for 38 years of my career, so I didn't really – the Tennessee program was – about the only place I kind of learned under. And you decide what you're going to do, and you decide what you're not going to do. I decided at times Coach Mears would have 30-minute talks before they'd go out and practice. And those guys came out of there shaking their heads. I mean, every now and then that's okay, but every day, and practicing 3 hours every day, it's too much, I think. We had a question about what are guys doing outside of practice. Sometimes nothing's better. Sometimes getting away from it because you're already practicing mandatorily as much as you can by rules. Sometimes having a break and being a regular student does you as much good as if it's up to the player and they want to be in there, that's great. And we love it as coaches when they do. But asking too much of them all the time, and it becomes a job and it's not fun. I would tell guys in recruiting and their parents, and I meant it, if you come to school here and play basketball and it's not enjoyable and you don't have fun while you're here doing it, then I'm not doing my job. And I will throw this in with zero humility, since we're talking about that. We only had two guys in the last 15 plus years transfer out of our program. So the focus on trying to make it a great experience for all your players. Now, Belmont's a great school, and I could attract terrific young men, but I chose the kind of guys we had, and I tried hard to choose guys that were self-starters, that worked hard, that were competitive, that knew how to play the game, but more than anything, had high character. And you know, we didn't win huge at the highest level of college athletics, and it gets harder and harder to do some of that stuff as you climb. But I do think everybody else in the OVC and the Atlantic Sun before that was trying hard every way they could to win games. And we did it with good guys, and they acted like good guys.
Do you think it was a better game back then than it is now?
No, I watched Tennessee beat Temple 11-6 one time.
Yep.
1973. Every time that there's a rule change, I'm kind of halfway against it. I wasn't for the three-point shot, and we've made more three-pointers than anybody in the country over the last 20-something years. Since we turned Division One, we've made more than anybody. Alex said something about Arkansas takes 33% of their shots from three. We took 50. We took half our shots. And we could get into the analytics and all that. If you recruit to it, then just need to make a third of those to compared to half of in the two-point shots. But there's some good and bad. They had to do something. I ended up being the chair of the Men's Basketball Rules Committee in 2015 when we made a lot of significant changes to the game because scoring was going way down, and we reduced the shot clock to 30, which I don't think has had really a very significant effect. But we allowed better freedom of movement. Officials are educated in that area, and scoring went up. But the real reason scoring goes down is because I think the majority of coaches in the country are defensive first coaches. You're looking at one right here. Rick Barnes is a tremendous defensive coach. And although they're not great offensively right now, they're still really good defensively with a young team. They're having to teach, bring a guy in and teach him all your defensive principles in 3 days and he starts the next game or whatever the case is. That's hard. And he's really, really – I think coaches recruit to defense, great athletes, long, quick, fast, and then they try to figure out ways to score. And that scenario right there just means lower scoring. And it's okay. I mean, it's nothing illegal. It's great. I was an offensive-minded kind of guy. That's why Burton came, right, Burton? Wanted to shoot, let him shoot it, green light. But most coaches are defensive-minded coaches, and they take defensive players before they'll take players with skill. So I think that, and then you have to change rules to make up for a difference that's occurring naturally because of the focus, I think. And we did that, and we got them going up, but they're starting to go down. I think the game's going back to a little bit too much physicalness, if that's a word. How about Mike Edwards? Mike Edwards would have scored 7,000 points. Maravich would certainly be one you'd pick as a guy that did it. But it changed the game, and I in the long haul, I think it's probably made it a more exciting game. But to me, it's kind of the opposite way. I always thought before that the closer you could get the ball to the basket offensively by what you were doing was better coaching, better. You got better shots by getting closer to the goal. Then all of a sudden they draw a line out there and you get better shots by getting further away from them. Why don't they draw another one, you get 4 points. And another one, you get 6. Okay, I don't know. That's kind of why I was against it to begin with. I just thought philosophically the best teams get the ball inside and that's better coaching. Now you're going to change all that, but you got to adjust.
It's time to shut her down for another weekend. Thanks for watching Tip Off Lowdown. Have a great weekend, and we'll see you at the game.
Tip Off Lowdown with the Big Orange Tip Off Club is brought to you by your area Pilot Food Marts and Pilot's My Rewards Loyalty Card. And Prompt Physical Therapy next to Lakeshore Park in Bearden.